Hey guys, welcome to another Visual Basic tutorial by the Magic Monk. This tutorial is actually requested by one of the YouTube users who needs some help with an assignment. So here it is. The first thing I want to talk about is how to open up a text file and load up the text file and print the contents in your program. Now, the reason why you want to be able to do that is because later on we're going to teach you guys how to save data into a text file. But that's a bit more complicated, so the first thing we're going to do is learn how to open up the file first. Okay, so the first thing I want you guys to do is click on New Project. So I've just opened up Visual Basic 2010 Express. And so right now, this is just the welcome screen. And I want you guys to click on New Project. And I just want a Windows Form application. And the name of it, I'm going to call it Text File Tutorial 1. Text file tutorial 1. So I'm going to click OK. And you can see that the project's being created. Now what I want you to do is click save. Save all. And then where it says save project, I want you to remember the location of the project and the name of the project and click save. Okay, so now that we have saved the project, make sure you really did click save all, otherwise it's not going to work. What we're going to do now is simply, in this project, create a button and a label. Now what's going to happen is, when I click this button, we're going to load up a text file, and the contents of that text file is going to be displayed in this label. Okay, so I'm going to call this button read from file. So click on that and change the text to read from file. So now you can see the button has, the words have just changed. And now we're going to double click on the button and we're going to enter in some code for the button. And the first line of code, I'm going to type in DIM space file num as integer equals free file brackets. Now what this does is the free file function, what it does is it returns an integer value that represents the next file number available. So basically every file that you open up is going to have a file number. And people who get mixed up with which file number represents which file, they'll probably lose track of what file numbers they have used. So free file is simply a function that returns a number where there's a spare integer value for your file to be assigned to your file. So anyway, that integer is going to be stored in the variable file num. And I'm gonna declare another variable called string. Temp s as string, and we're gonna explain what that does in a second. But basically, right now, all you need to understand is it's a string variable called temp s. And I'm also going to declare another string variable called temp l Okay, so we have three variables. The first string variable has a value of nothing, and the second string variable has not been assigned any values. Okay, now we're going to run the function file open. And this is the function that opens the text file. Now the first argument that it wants is the file number. Now notice how we have already stored the file number into a variable called file num. So that's the first thing we type in. And then the next thing it wants is the file name as a string. Now I'm just going to put in quotation mark tests.txt, and we're going to create that file very soon. Actually, let's call it score.txt, and we're going to create that file in a second. And then you're going to type in open mode dot, and you can see there's five options here. And basically, you need to decide what you're opening your file up for. If you're opening it to write to it, or to read from it, or to append to it. Now, right now, we just want to read from it, so it's open mode.input. And you can think of this as inputting the contents of that file into our program. So that's why it's called input. Okay, and now we want to use a do until loop. Now, the difference between do until and do while is that do until will repeat a set of instructions until this condition here is true. So basically, right now, this condition is false, so it will keep repeating everything that I'm putting in this section. Now, what does this part say? This part is saying that until the end of the file has been reached, right? So this is file number, whatever number it is. We've opened it up, and we're going to keep working on whatever it is that we tell it to do until we reach the end of the file. So what are we going to do? Well, that's going to require us to use the templ variable, which we created earlier. And what we're going to do is we're going to get one line at a time. So this is going to get the first line. So line input. Basically, it reads a single line from the file. So it's going to read that first line from this file number, which is score.txt. So it's going to read that first line and put the contents into the variable templ. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add this whole line into our string variable temps. So temps is going to equal, I'm going to use the increment operator. So I'm adding temp string to temp line. So basically, temps is going to contain what it had before plus templ. And then I'm going to add a line break, which is represented by this variable. So this represents a return character, which is a line break. Okay, so now we're going to keep looping this. And then I'm going to close the file. And the last thing I want to do is I want to display everything in tempS, which is going to contain the whole file into the label. So label1.txt going to equal temp s. Okay, now I want you to now click run. All right, start debugging and see what happens. So save it first, Control S, click the play button or debug button, and then you will see the application with a button you can press. So press that button and you will see an error. What is the error? It cannot find your text file. So that is all part of the plan. So now we're going to copy this file path, and I'm going to open up this file, this folder, according to that path. So that path is located here. Right, so I've just opened it up from my computer, and within this folder I'm going to right click and create a text file. So new text document, and I'm going to call it score.txt. And what am I going to put in this file? Well, right now I'm just going to put in my name, and let's say a score that I got from Tetris or whatever game that I have played. And then I might do it for my brother as well. Okay, so I'm gonna save this file, close it, close this folder. I'm gonna stop it, and I'm going to run this file, run this program again. And this time when I click read from file, it reads my text file and puts it in the label. Okay, so hopefully you got something out of this tutorial. See you again next time.